You know, I just this inauguration was going to be different even before the events of a couple weeks ago because of COVID. So when you've had such a key role in making this go off, what are your thoughts as you go into an inauguration that is going to be different than any we have ever seen, both because of COVID and because of the security impacts?
I believe we have to cherish our democracy even more, that we really learned from 2 weeks ago. We can't take it for granted. And that's why, despite all the changes that we can't have as many people there because of COVID, because instead we're lining the mall with this beautiful field of flags, which I think really reflects the moment we're in. We are going to be assembled on a platform which only 2 weeks ago was mobbed by an angry group of insurrectionists. You literally are going to see the spray paint at the bottom of the columns. I was just up there yesterday. But it is still going to be beautiful. Why? Because we have the leadership, Vice President Pence, former President Bush, former President Obama, everyone up there to say, we welcome these new leaders, we wish them well, and this is our country. For 244 years of democracy, we have seen peaceful transfers of power. And that is what you're going to see up on that stage tomorrow. And I'm honored to be part of it. I think it's going to be a majestic moment, even though it's going to look so different.
In terms of security, you've had to, I imagine, reconfigure this a lot. Are you confident that the security situation is locked down, that there will be no threats to the president or the vice president?
Well, as in past inaugurations, this is run by the Secret Service, so it's a whole different thing than what was going on at the Capitol. They have military defense departments been involved planning this for the past year, and you see there's a major military presence. I trust them, the Secret Service, to make the right decisions here. So far, this is going very well. And usually you have, you know, millions of people, which we're not having because of COVID. And so that will allow the military to focus more on the security issues.
And you will be speaking in addition to Yes. being on the committee that plans this, right?
I think Minnesotans will be seeing me there quite a bit. I'll be speaking. I'll be introducing a number of people. I'll be at the prayer church service in the morning with the Bidens. And then I'll actually be giving them a gift, official gift afterward in the Hall of States, which are some vases that are traditionally made in Pennsylvania. Our hope is that I don't drop it. It is 32 pounds with the base. And so I will basically be there through the day with Senator Blunt leading the inauguration.
What an honor.
Yes.
And when all is said and done, you know, what do you hope this country and the rest of the world takes from the event?
I hope they take the sense that our country always finds a way to move forward, even through this pandemic, even through the security nightmare that we experienced 2 weeks ago, that our country is bigger than that and our hearts are bigger than that. And they will be able to hear a new president outline his vision. As he said, whether you supported him or not, he wants to reach out to everyone. And I think that's a really good message to see next week.